intimacy and male female relation. When you have given your heart to a man or a woman, you need to share everything that arises in your heart. There should be nothing private. Everything should be shared. This requires understanding, and understanding comes when meditation attains to fruition. Pain and pleasure, this represents the duality of emotions. Both should be shared. Normally, this is not so. We only want to share pleasure, happiness. Purposely, I am using the word pleasure because pain and pleasure go together as pair of opposites. And this pair represents the psychological factors that concerns each one of us. This authenticity of sharing your heart will bring an intimacy which is not ordinarily seen in married couples or couples who are together. Married people are never intimate. They simply pretend to be intimate. Their intimacy has a motive in it. Maybe to pretend to be intimate is good for children. To pretend to be intimate is good for one's own financial affairs, future securities, respectability in society. But intimacy is not there in the real sense. It is more a formal thing. It happens always like this in almost all relations. There are no moments of silence between couples. As lovers and beloved, there have always been moments of silence between the two. Then you could remain silent, just holding the hands together and feeling the surge of refreshing energy. Or you can go on looking at one another in the moments of silence. Such is not the situation between husbands and wives. They are always talking. No quarreling all the while, but they get silent only when they are angry after a wrestling bout. You may be fighting with your man or a woman, and a friend knocks on the door. Suddenly everything changes and you start smiling at one another. The mind comes in and everything is going so beautifully, and just a moment before you were ready to kill one another. What happened? This is just a social phase. You are not only deceiving the friend, instead you are deceiving yourself as well. So I am telling you to move into being. It is arduous and dangerous in the beginning. One never knows what will happen. But one thing is certain. If you can move through being, pain will cleanse you of many impurities, of many gross elements in you. Certainly it does, and it will. If you move through pain, pain will cleanse you of many impurities, of many gross elements in you. Certainly it will make you more subtle and more aware too. And through pain, you will become available to pleasure or happiness as well. When one is ready to suffer pain, there is no point in repressing happiness. We repress happiness, pleasure, because we are afraid that if we allow pleasure to have total possession, the pain will also come with it. It is the other side of the coin. It will come certainly. So people do not go into pleasure totally. They go very cautiously. Even while making love, people do not abandon themselves. They remain in control of oneself. A subtle control, a remote control, they continue with. They keep the button in their hand somewhere. If something goes too far, they are crossing the boundaries, they turn off the remote. But they never go to the very end of it. The fear is that if you go too much into pleasure, you may be entering into the forbidden territory of pain. It is always there, and this is the pain. So start with pain. And if you can be open in pain, and if you want some time to cry, then do so. Where else will you cry if you cannot cry before your man or a woman? Forget all nonsense that has been taught that a man never cries. If a man never cries, he is not a man. Either he is inhuman or he is Superman. But one thing is certain, he is not man. Cry sometimes. Share your sorrows and your sadness. Weep like a child in totality. Crying will clear many suppressed emotions. Crying is therapeutic. And the same I am saying to your partner, she has to do the same. And by, you will see that a great intimacy is arising, which has nothing to do with society. And with that intimacy, your happiness will happen. A different kind of. You will explode into happiness, but begin with pain. And always remember that everything has to begin in pain. When you are in labor, there is pain. In childbirth, there is pain. And this pain leads to the explosion of joy when the child is born. Meditate together and open your hearts as they are. Sometimes wrong, sometimes rotten, and other times not worth showing to anybody, yet still show it to your beloved. In this way, you will also help her to show everything. Intimacy means there is no fear of any kind between the two. There is total freedom to express whatever you want to express to your beloved. You remember you stand totally nude in front of one another. But psychological nudity is more important than the physical nudity. We focus on the physical nudity, not the psychological nudity. We cherish the physical, but we do not cherish the psychological nudity because there are many fears. Intimacy is not biological nudeness. Intimacy is the psychological aspect. It is when you are in the room, I will be as if I am alone. Your presence will not make me repress anything. Your presence will not make me change and show something else which is not there. I will be as natural as I am in the bathroom when I am alone. Then there is intimacy. We focus on physical intimacy, shift from physical intimacy to psychological intimacy. There is a risk in it. One never knows what will come out of it. But one can be said certainly, whatsoever comes will be beautiful. If separation comes out of it, it will be beautiful, better, more beautiful than the so-called marriage. If marriage comes out of it, it will be tremendously beautiful. If there is existing relationship, it will continue its journey for fruition. But the intimacy, the psychological freedom, the psychological nudeness is very important between couples. This is the way you can allow love to blossom. Freedom to to attain to a new dimension, and your bliss will begin to evolve out of this.